the biggest challenge I think, we have is, finding bands that are available, first of all, is your first challenge. That starts, 6 months, 8 months out, trying to get the bands that we think are going to be, suitable for what we think is a good festival. And once you've determined that and have got the bands, now it's putting all the work together to get the park ready, to get the contracts in place, and really the volunteers to make it, they really make it happen. Let's face it. They're the heartbeat of the festival.
It is free, which is crazy to me. But how do you guys pull this off? Where do the funds come from? Because, I'm sure these bands love to play, but they're definitely not free.
For sure. Yeah, bands are a business. We are a not-for-profit, and we definitely want to keep this a free festival. Like you said, Canada's largest free music festival. We rely on a lot of funding from the local community and from the government as well. So for us to keep this free, the local support, the local community has been great to really help us with this. And the government, does have funding available, but over the years, it started to fall off. And it's going to continue to be a tough go for a lot of festivals going forward. So we're really grateful to the local community and to the government for what they do give us. But, we've seen a few festivals already this year that won't be back due to lack of funding. The other option is to charge. And again, that's not something that we're looking at this time. And we'd like to keep it for free for all of our community.
Yeah, no doubt. And Burlington is known for the Sound of Music Festival. And, we talked about their funding and the fact that it is Canada's largest free festival. And you guys have really gone with a Canadian theme this year, at least from what I'm looking at. I mean, names like Trooper, Jim Cuddy, Lows to the Low, Chilliwack, the Northern Pikes. And we can't have a Canadian festival without Kim Mitchell. Was that the thought process of let's go Canadian this year?
It definitely was. And we're in our 45th year. And I think it was really important for us as a festival and as a community to really focus on Canadiana.
There are a couple imports as well, in particular one that I wanted to spotlight. I mean, being a 90s kid myself, Spin Doctors rolling through town. What possessed you to bring the Spin Doctors in? They still have a pocket full of kryptonite, and they do have more songs than just two princes, I promise you.
That is true. I mean, Little Miss Can't Be Wrong is another great song they have. So myself, a 90s child as well, and love the that era and that grunge scene and the Spin Doctors as well. But they happened to be available. It was something they wanted to do as well, too. They really bought into our agenda, and we're super lucky to get them because they're not a band that comes around very often and are available at this time. So we're really excited to see them play.
Now, I know a couple of things you did want to spotlight here before we go is both accessibility and diversity that are happening this year at the Sound of Music. Tell me.
Yeah, accessibility, diversity, inclusion is really important to us as a community and as a festival. We have an accessibility committee set up through our volunteers. And again, just to note, everyone at the festival is a volunteer. We have no paid employees. Diversity is important for all of our acts and all of our patrons. So for us to be the leader in that in a free music festival scene is super important to us. And it really shows what this community is all about.
Well, it is June 13th to 16th. Burlington is going to be buzzing with the Sound of Music Festival. Dave, all the best with the event, and I hope it goes great this year and comes back around to do it again next year. Thanks so much for doing this.
Thanks for having me, and hopefully I see you at the festival. Let your light shine in.